Good afternoon, everyone. It's good to be together here at St. Charles Borromeo as we celebrate Stefan and Megan's wedding together. We celebrate that we've been baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Stefan, Juan, Megan, Seville, the church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you. Together with your family and friends, in the presence of God, our Father, you establish between yourself a lifelong partnership. Jeremiah, the reading you chose, calls it a covenant. So does the church. May the Lord hear you on this, your joyful day. May he send your help from heaven, send you help from heaven and protect you. May he grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, you who since the beginning of the world have blessed the increase of offspring, Show favor to our supplications and pour forth your help of the help of your blessing on these your servants, Megan and Stephan, so that in the union of marriage they may be bound together in mutual affection and likeness of mind and in shared holiness. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Let's be seated for the Word of God. Listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant I made with their fathers, the day I took them by the hand to lead them forth from the land of Egypt. But this is the covenant which I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will place my law within them and write it upon their hearts. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer will they have need to teach their friends and relatives how to know the Lord. All, from least to greatest, shall know me, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Slow to anger and rich in compassion. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and O my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. He will not always chide, nor does he keep his wrath forever. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing it is kindness toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he put our transgressions from us. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, let mutual love continue. Do not neglect hospitality, for through it some have unknowingly entertained angels. Be mindful of prisoners as if sharing their imprisonment, and of the ill-treated as of yourselves, for you also are in the body. Let marriage be honored among all, and the marriage bed be kept undefiled. Let your life be free from love of money, but be content with what you have. For he has said, I will never forsake you or abandon you. Thus we may say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, and I will not be afraid. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. 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 If we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said, "From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. And the two shall become one. Congratulations, Megan and Stefan, as you are choosing a good life, the married life. Yet that doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be an easy life. We're all different. And sometimes over the years, with my priest group, I've been in with the same group one died, but now we have six again. And we're reflecting how when we were younger, thought how difficult a celibate life would be. And it's kind of hard to not stay away, not choose marriage, but felt called to this other life. And yet as we go on, we think sometimes married life is even more challenging because you're not the same people. And over the years, there's going to be kind of like a refining of each other if you stay true to the journey taking off the rough edges. So that's why we all have to have relationships that maybe change us and challenge us and as we enter in the journey. But you're choosing in a very particular way to be on this journey together, and the two shall become one. One of my favorite passages is from Matthew chapter 11, and it says, Jesus says, "Come to me, take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble of heart. Your souls will find rest." But taking a yoke, there is a certain sense of taking Jesus' yoke on you, but also you're choosing to be yoked together for a lifetime. That's an image of marriage. And you're choosing that for each other. I think it's a great time to get married during Advent. And I saw this Advent wreath a long time ago in Lookout Abbey. It was an abbey in South Dakota. And just the notion of the journey every year is kind of cyclical. Winter, spring, summer, fall. Winter, spring, summer, fall. The planets are rotating, and right now Jupiter and Saturn are coming together at a certain time. Last time they were visible like this is 800 years ago. So this is a special time. And anyway, then there's sunrise, sunset, and you go, but we're not just going in circular matter. Life is cyclical, but we are moving somewhere. And as a couple, you're moving up that mountain to the Lord. You're helping each other do it together. And there will be times when it gets steep. But being yoked together, you will help each other. And maybe one child, two child, three child, each one will be a little bit different. Or another image, you know, like when you have your light, your baptismal light, you want to keep burning. And you're united as one, and yet you each have your own lights. And from this angle, you know, on this level, you can't see the joy that's around the corner. But if you stick to the journey, there's that, the joyful Sunday. That was last Sunday, we call it Gaudete in Latin, called rejoice in the Lord always. I say it again, rejoice. But the journey, and the two shall become one. That is a wonderful image for your marriage. Not many people choose Hebrews for the second reading. It's a great reading, though. Do not neglect hospitality, for some have entertained angels. Your home, in the blessing, it talks about your home should be a blessing to others. And may it be. And when people enter in that home, they feel that hospitality and that care. Be mindful of prisoners. Most people don't want to think about prisoners, but Jesus himself took the part of a prisoner in Matthew when I was in prison. You came to visit me. And the ill-treated, be mindful of them. I think this is coming a little bit from the teacher element. And let marriage be honored by all. Let your life be free from love of money. From love of money. In Timothy, St. Paul writes to Timothy and says, the root of all evil is the love of money. Because whenever we love money, then usually God is put in second place. And our neighbor and maybe even our spouse is put in second place. Let your life be free from love of money. I didn't know it, but when Megan and Stefan came to me, I had this on my wall, and it's El pueblo de Chimbote está agradecido por su amor y amistad. And that's the people of Chimbote are grateful or thankful for your love and your friendship. And Megan says, I have one of those too. So she's been to Chimbote, Peru, which is one of the poorest areas in the whole world. Real poverty, people struggling to just eat. And so you know that part. And I'm sure you will both be introduced as you go along fuller to shape each other in this kind of journey. So that let your life be free from the love of money and you'll be happy. Be content with what you have. That goes on, Hebrews. It's hard to be content with what we have, especially when we are always noticing what we don't have, rather than thanking God for what we do have. And I know things have changed a lot in this last, you know, since we started. Well, we were hoping that everything would be over with. And they were feeling so bad for these other couples that were getting married in the midst of that pandemic and they couldn't have everybody here. And then all of a sudden they realized they're going to be in the same situation. But didn't really complain. And I'm really grateful for the way you've handled the whole thing with grace and love. And just the most important thing, not going to change your wedding, you're going to be yoked together in Christ. That's why you come here in the first place. You know, to receive Christ and to make this commitment in the context of your commitment to Christ. Jeremiah says, "This I will write a new covenant and place a law within their hearts, within them, and write it on their hearts." Well, marriage is a wonderful thing to do that God can write his covenant, his love on your hearts. As you make a covenant, a commitment to each other for a lifetime, it's more than a contract. I mean, society sees it as a contract. But we see it as almost like a blood relationship you're establishing with God and each other And we receive the blood of Christ, the body and blood of Christ, his glorified body and blood of Christ from this altar. And you, that saint, that blood runs through your veins. And as you make that commitment in this context, it is a wonderful help as you continue this journey, as you two are becoming one in Christ and making the journey of your life. The most important thing in the end is that we're all in heaven together. And may we all be faithful to praying for you, all of us, and helping them on that journey as they're committing to each other. And the two shall become one. So let's proceed. As you make your commitment before the Lord, would the wedding party please stand together and come forward, as the congregation remains seated, come forward. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion. I think it's nice if you can see their faces and not just me. So let's turn it around. That's their bitter side. Dearly beloved, you have come together in the church, in the house of the church, so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter marriage may be made known. May you be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens you who are already consecrated in holy baptism, that you may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church's minister and all those present, I ask you to state your intentions. Stefan, Megan, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly? If so, say, I have. Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I am. Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and the church? If so, say, I am. It's wonderful. Since it is your marriage, the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands facing each other and declare your consent before God and his church.
I, Stefan, take you, Megan, to be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to honor you.
To love and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Megan, take you, Stefan, to be my husband.
I, Megan, take you, Stefan, to be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In
sickness and in health.
To love you and to honor you.
To love you and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
No couples in Ireland. They need the support of relatives, friends, and the whole community. Are all of you ready and willing to support them in their commitment of love? If so, say we are. We are. May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you what God joins together, let no one put asunder.
The rings, please.
Lord, bless and consecrate Megan and Stefan in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Megan, receive this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Stefan, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord is faithful. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger and rich in compassion.
Well, when we make these kind of commitments, they're life commitments, they can't happen without staying in prayer. And so we stand together as the wedding party goes back to their places. Let us stand together and bring our prayers before such a loving God that will help us. God is love, and those who remain in love remain in God. So we bring our prayers, praying that we all may remain in love, and for Stefan and Megan.
For the church and its leaders, may our commitment to the gospel lead us to deepen our faith and trust in God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world and its leaders, may all people be treated with dignity they deserve as God's children, we pray to the Lord. For our country and those who defend it, may our men and women who serve in the military or as emergency personnel be kept safe from all harm, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, lonely, or depressed, may they be strengthened by God's love and aided by friends and family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our guests gathered here, online, and whatever way they are with us, may they enjoy the warm company of family and friends and have safe travel and good health, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Megan and Stefan, may they live long, blessed lives together. May their love grow stronger each and every day, and may they build a family rooted in faith and unconditional love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Bertie Huebner, Bill Huebner, Lauren Seville, Steve Froseth, and all who have died, including all the relatives and friends of Megan and Stefan, may they know the peace and fullness of eternal life with God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, you have taught us to seek through Jesus, to knock, and the door will be opened. We have just done so, confident that as we continue our prayers through life, you will give us help and guidance and help others through our prayers. We ask this all in the Holy Spirit through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated as the altar is prepared. We walk by faith and not by sight. No gracious words we hear of him who spoke as none e'er spoke, but we believe him here. We may not touch his hands or side or follow where he trod, yet in his promise we rejoice and cry, my Lord and God. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. May the Lord wash away my iniquity and cleanse you of all my sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Amen. Receive in your kindness, Lord, the offerings we bring in gladness before you, and in your fatherly love, watch over those you have joined in the sacrament of sacramental covenant, Megan and Stefan. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in him you have made a new covenant with your people, so that as you have redeemed man and woman by the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, so in Christ you might make them partakers of divine nature and joint heirs with him of heavenly glory. In the union of husband and wife, you give a sign of Christ's loving gift of grace, so that in the sacrament we celebrate here might draw us back more deeply into the wondrous design of your love. And so with the angels and all the saints, we praise you, and without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. May you kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Charles Borromeo, our patron, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, with them we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life and may praise and glorify you through Christ, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. A special nuptial blessing, if you want to kneel to receive the nuptial blessing. O God, who by your might, your mighty power, created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with a one blessing not forfeited by original sin, nor washed away by the flood. Look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask, Megan and Stefan ask, to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of your love and grace, may the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter Megan, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May Stefan, her husband, entrust his heart to her so that, acknowledging her as his equal and as his joint heir to the life of grace, he may grow and show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, made one in flesh. May they be blameless in all they do. And with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children, and grant that reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us share with each other from a distance a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. By the power of this sacrament, O Lord, accompany with your loving favor what in your providence you have instituted, so as to make of one heart in love those you have already joined in this holy union, and replenished with the one bread and the one chalice, through Christ our Lord. I'm not sure if it was a foreshadowing, but I swore I heard a baby. Well, we come to the final part where the wedding party, please come forward. Turn you around again. May God, the all-powerful Father, grant you his joy and bless you and your children forever and ever. Amen. May the only begotten Son of God stand by you with compassion in good times and in bad. Amen. And may the Holy Spirit of God always pour forth his love into your hearts forever and ever. Amen. May God bless and keep you. May God's face shine on you. May God be kind to you and give you peace. May Almighty God bless you and all of you who are gathered here in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go forth to continue this celebration. You're going to be joining in a meal, so we just ask the Lord's blessing upon that meal and your gathering and keep you all safe. And on your conversation, bless the food that you'll be receiving together, and may it be an occasion of joy and love. And as you continue your celebration, may you experience God's care for you through the love of others. And we continue this celebration of Stefan and Megan Quant as husband and wife. Whenever you want to go.
parents of the room. And there she is, all in her lovely glory. You're in live.
We're on live.
Oh, okay, thanks.
Here are the people gathered. Whoops, there he is.
Focus on him.
There he is. Got a lot of sun there. Kind of hard to focus on that face. Oh my gosh, it is good. Here are all the people. And there they are.
I'll text you. Whoops, sorry.
Oh, there she is. You're on live. There are people watching you. They're happy. Was that the baby that was making a noise?
No, I think it was the other one.
No. What a cutie. These guys are not as cute, but not bad.
I get that a lot.
I'm going to break up a conversation here. Go down the hallway.
Yeah, that was naughty.
There's the father of the groom. Oh, there's the father of the bride.
Yeah, I believe.
And there's two young guys. Now here's some others. Oh, was this the baby that was talking?
No, he just showed up.
No, he just showed up. They're all looking at you. I'm going to close the video. Well, I got one more baby here. Was this the baby talking?
She might have been one of them.
This is their live watching you.
All right.
Hi.